What do you need to be looking for in your entry-level clinical research position? Up next after the intro. Hey guys, ECRG here, back with another video. In this video, we're going to be talking about what to look for in an entry-level clinical research position. So we've talked about a lot on this channel how to get into the entry-level clinical research position, how to get your foot in the door. We've talked about your resumes. We've talked a lot about networking to get in. We've talked about all these ways to get in. But what exactly are we looking for? What is that perfect position to start your career in the entry-level clinical research field? So I've got you guys covered today. I've got five things to look for in that first entry-level position in clinical research. So without further ado, we're gonna go ahead and get into it. But first, we're gonna talk about the resume review program that we currently have going on. Email us your resume, eliteclinicalgroup@gmail.com. If you are unsure or hesitant about your resume, just wanna have it looked over, just want to improve your resume, we've got you covered. Email us at eliteclinicalgroup@gmail.com. We'll take it to the next level. So look out for that. Also, we are doing interview prep also. So you can reach out at our email address again if you want to practice. If you've got an interview coming up, we will practice with you one-on-one and we will help you feel more confident and more comfortable in that clinical research interview. Wouldn't it be great if you had already heard all those questions that they're going to ask you again? You've already gone through them once before. So that would do worlds for your confidence and strongly increase your chances to get into the field. So the first thing that you want to look for in that entry-level clinical research role is what kind of experience are you going to be getting? What kind of learning is going to be taking place? So a lot of times they just throw you into the field, they just throw you into the job that you're gonna have, and you feel like you're either sinking or swimming. So are they gonna teach you? Is there gonna be a training program? Is there gonna be a training period, you know, a couple months where they're gonna train you up on the job before you're actually thrown into to different studies in the clinical research field? Also, what kind of experience are you gonna be getting? Are you gonna be there just uploading documents into the TMF, you know, scanning documents in? Or are you gonna be able to interact with different team members? Are you gonna be able to interact with the client? Are you gonna be able to interact with the clinical team? Are you gonna be able to interact with the project management team, data management team, medical monitor team? Whatever it is you wanna do and whatever the type of experience you wanna gain, are you gonna be able to get that from your entry-level position? So first thing you want to look for is make sure you're getting good learning and good experience in your entry-level role. The second thing you want to look for is the management. Are you going to have good managers? Now, this can be kind of hard to know up front or just from a 30-minute, an hour, hour and a half interview, but this is where networking comes into play. There are certain companies that are really known for their management and management style. Par Excel, just to name one. Par Excel has been known for years to have some of the best managers in the game. So are they a company like Par Excel where they're known to have really good managers? This is where you ask the recruiter. This is where you ask during your interview, how's the management style? How do you typically manage? Especially if you're gonna be interviewing with the person that you're actually is actually gonna be your manager. You can ask these questions during the interview about how the management is going to be. And this is really good because management are extremely, extremely responsible for your success. They're responsible in a large part for how much money you're gonna make, and they're responsible for when your promotion's gonna come about. So if you're interested in that kind of thing, progressing in promotion, which I'm sure a lot of people are, that management style is very important. And it also kind of goes into how much you're gonna learn versus your experience in your first role. They're gonna determine whether you're gonna sink or swim. The manager is there to put you in position to be successful in the clinical research field. And you really wanna make sure that you have a good manager and a good management team and a good you know, if you're in the project management world, if you got a good set of project managers around you that are really going to help you learn, get you the experience you need to get to that next level, and really have an enjoyable entry-level experience. So that's the second thing, is the management team. The third thing you want to look into when you're looking at your entry-level clinical research job is progression. Is there opportunity to progress? Is there opportunity to go to that next level? What's it like? What are the requirements? Are they easy to follow? We've done videos a lot of times about secrecy around certain positions in the clinical research world, specifically how to get to that next level of being a CRA. And there's a lot of smoke and mirrors that goes on in these CROs, with them not telling their internal candidates when positions are being released, not even having a clear pathway of how to get into that position. So we've got to know, once we accept a job, what's the progression going to be like? Or we want to know this before we accept the job, actually. How's the progression? Are there these opportunities available to us? And that the interview, once again, is a great opportunity to ask these questions about progression, where you can ask the hiring manager, the recruiter, and all the people you interview with. It's is there a possibility for progression, and does it happen on a timely manner? Okay. So number three, progression. And then the fourth thing we want to look for in an entry-level clinical research role, how are the people? These are the people we're going to be working in for at least 8 hours a day, every single day, 5 days out the week. We spend more time with the people at work than we do with our own family and loved ones. And that's just a fact of life, at least in America. So you want to make sure that you are actually going to be there with people that you enjoy being with, that are friendly and kind, and that are there to help progress you in your career. You want to make sure that you can actually, you know, tolerate these people for that length of time. Because if you can't, then that's going to be a problem. You're not going to be in that position very long, because the work is just going to be very unenjoyable, and it's going to make your clinical research experience bad. So you want to make sure that the people around you are good, and you can find this out on the Glassdoor reviews. We have Glassdoors coming out, if not already, and we're going to be doing a series of Glassdoor reviews, so you can look out for that. But there's all these different opportunities to look and see how the people are. You know, you can look on LinkedIn, you can talk with your network. Glassdoor, again, Indeed has this, Monster has it, reviews on the company. So there are all these opportunities out there to learn how are the people at the company. And then the fifth and final thing you should be looking at, and this is number five on the list for a reason, because it's not as important as the others, is the money. And really, by money, I mean enough money. Because when in your entry-level role, your goal is, you're not trying to become rich off that one role. Your goal is to get in there, learn the basics, learn the foundation. That's your number one goal in this entry-level role. Your number one goal is to learn as much as possible about clinical research. Build a strong foundation that you can build upon for years to come. It's not trying to make as much money as possible and, you know, go so you can buy a BMW or a Mercedes-Benz or whatever you want to do with that, or a giant house. That's not your goal. Your goal is to learn as much as possible, so then 5-10 years down the line, then you can buy all that stuff that you want to buy. Then you can take all those fancy vacations, et cetera, et cetera. But first, you've got to learn and get as much experience as possible. But all that becomes nothing if you're making poverty wages and you've got to, you know, be homeless. That's not what we're trying to do in clinical research here. Clinical research is a great field because you can make pretty good money, more than most in a rather, you know, decent amount of time. And, you know, you're not going to be like starving and living out of your car for the first couple of years. You should be able to make a decent amount of money, and I'm not going to put a number on it because it's different for everywhere all over the country and the world, but you should be able to make enough money where you can get by and be comfortable. And That's the fifth. Those are the five reasons what to look for. Five things you need to look for in your entry-level clinical research job. So one, we've got learning and experience. Two, we've got management and managers. Three, we've got career progression. Four, we've got good people. And five, and finally, we've got the money. So comment down below what you think you should be looking for in an entry-level clinical research position. Do you think my order is messed up? Do you feel like a lot of things are out of order? Would there be anything you would add or take away from this list? So comment down below. If you're listening on YouTube, if you're listening on the podcast, well, I guess you can just email us what you think about this list. We'll respond back. So once again, guys, if you're interested in getting one-on-one coaching or one-on-one interview prep, email us. If you are also interested in getting your resume reviewed, email us once again. I'm also thinking about getting a phone number for you guys in case you guys like texting better than email. So if you like that idea, you can comment down below and see what, and see if we do that. If enough people do that, then we'll do it. But all right, guys, like, share, subscribe. Appreciate you guys. Take care.